specific heat capacity is amount of heat absorbed by 1 kg of substance. Okay, it's the amount of heat absorbed by 1 kg of 1 kg of substance to increase the temperature by 1 degree Celsius. Okay. So S should be equal to what? Delta Q divided by M into delta P. Find out. No. Delta Q will be equal to M S delta T by definition itself. Okay. Now this specific heat is different for different material. Okay, for iron it is something, for steel it is something else, for copper it is something else, like that. Getting it? Okay, so if temperature is increased, heat will be absorbed. If temperature is decreased, same heat will be released. Okay, so if you already know that the decrease in temperature is like release of heat, an increase of temperature is absorption of heat, you don't care about the sign coming in. You always subtract lower temperature from higher temperature. You take the modulus of it. Okay, let's suppose change in temperature is 5 degrees Celsius. Okay, whether it is increase or decrease, the quantum of heat is same, whether it is released or absorbed, right? So that's how you deal with, and then you find out the heat involved in the process, M S delta T. Any doubt here? No? I think this concept was introduced in class 10th, 9th. In chemistry? MCV delta T, that is molar specific heat. Now, this specific heat capacity is a very good, physical parameter for liquids and for solids. For gases, the situation becomes little tricky. Okay? The problem is this. Let me give you an example. Suppose you are cooking a food inside a pressure cooker, and suppose you are cooking food in an open utensil. Where the food will be cooked faster? Pressure cooker. Why? Because temperature increases faster inside the pressure cooker. Okay, same gas is there, same gas, atmospheric gas only is there, but it is able to increase its temperature more if it is inside the pressure cooker with the same amount of heat. What is so special in the pressure cooker? The volume is constant. Okay, when it is open utensil, what is constant? Pressure is constant. Okay. So, for gases, we need to also take into account that whether it is a constant volume or constant pressure process. Okay? So constant volume, specific heat is different. Constant pressure, it is different. Okay? You learn more about it in thermodynamics. What happens is that the some amount of heat which gas absorbs goes into expansion when you are allowing it to expand. Okay, but when you are enclosing it, it can't do any work. Whatever heat you give, entire heat gets converted into rise in temperature of that gas. Fine. So that is the reason why same amount of heat when you give in constant volume, the rise in temperature is more. So now tell me where the specific heat capacity will be more, in constant volume or in constant pressure. Same amount of heat, let's say I am giving delta Q, at constant volume delta T will be more, at constant pressure delta T is less, so delta Q by delta T is more in constant pressure, so at constant pressure specific heat of gas is more. Okay, and when we talk about gases, generally we like to deal in moles. Okay, so that is why the heat capacity is not defined per kg of a gas, but per mole of a gas. Okay, and we call it molar specific heat capacity. If you call it specific heat capacity, it is still per kg only. You have to specify it is molar specific heat capacity. Okay, so what should be the formula? At constant volume, molar specific heat is written as CV, which is equal to delta Q divided by what? N into delta T. N is number of moles. Okay, this is CV, heat is supplied at constant volume. Okay, CP is delta Q T divided by N into delta T. Okay, so if I give, let's say, 1 joule here, delta Q is 1 joule, here also 1 joule. Which delta T will be more, this or that? Constant volumes, delta T will be more. This is pressure cooker like scenario, right? Delta T is more, temperature rises faster, so denominator is more than this denominator. That is why this is lesser than that. Cp is more than Cv. Write down calorimetry. Calorie is what? A unit of heat energy. In a way, metry is measurement. It's like measuring something. Okay? So measurement of heat is calorimetry is a process of measuring the heat. Okay, so in the calorimetry we will learn about an experiment to measure the heat itself, or this experiment will help you calculate the specific heat of a particular substance. Getting it? Have you ever heard of calorimetric term before? You are in CBSE or ICSE? PUC. PUC. You? See, calorimetry uses a bucket sort of thing that is called calorimeter. Okay, so you have this calorimeter. Draw this. It is made up of an insulating material. You may want to put the foam inside or make it a wood. Okay, you are doing it so that there is no exchange of heat from the surrounding. Whatever happens inside remains inside. Okay, then you have to put a lid also at the top. And then, let's say it has water in it. Okay, now you are going to measure heat. So, what is the first instrument you should have? Thermometer, right? So there is a thermometer which goes like this. Okay, this is thermometer. You may want to open the lid and then drop a very hot iron ball inside so that heat is getting exchanged between iron ball and water, and based on that you draw some inferences. Okay, but when you do it, when it goes down, maybe water this side is hotter, that side water is colder, temperature is not uniform, then what you should need? Stirrer. Okay, so you have a stirrer also. It will just mix everything. Fine. So this is the calorimeter inside which you have exchange of heat which is happening. And the best part is there is no exchange of heat from the surrounding. That is assumption actually. There will be some exchange of heat anyways. Okay. But then, what will happen, inside the calorimeter, there will be some hot objects, write down, there will be hot objects. Before mixing, I am talking about, like, for example, this is a hot iron ball. Okay, there will be hot objects and then there will be cold objects. Of course, hot and cold, they are relative term, so I am saying the temperature difference is there. Okay, so now when they are coming in contact and you have a stirrer also, what will happen? Exchange of heat. Hot objects, what they will do? They will lose heat. They will lose heat energy. And what the cold objects will do? They will gain heat energy. Now, is the magnitude of loss in heat energy is equal to the magnitude of gain in heat energy? Yes or no? It will be, right? This is how you, this is nothing but conservation of energy only. This is how you use calorimeter to measure the heat. You're just equating the amount of heat that is lost by the hot object with the amount of heat that is absorbed by the colder object. Now, when you leave it like this, when the hot object comes in contact with the colder object and you, with a stirrer, you do all that and leave it for very long time, what will happen? Temperature becomes constant, both for hot as well as cold. Both will come at the same temperature. Initially, they may be having different temperature, but finally, they will come at the same temperature. Okay? It may happen that in a numerical, it is given, like, for example, X amount of heat is given out to the atmosphere. Then I think you are intelligent enough to equate, right? You can say that whatever heat hot object is releasing, that is equal to gain in heat energy by the colder object plus loss to the atmosphere, right? But majority of the time, there will not be any loss to the atmosphere. Okay, so all we have to do in a numerical related to calorimeter is equate loss in heat energy with gain in heat energy. Who will lose the heat energy? Hot object. And who will gain the heat energy? Colder objects. Very simple. Okay, shall we do a numerical? Remember, delta Q is what? Ms delta T. Fine. Till now, our assumption is we are not changing state. It will never happen that right now I can, you know, I can put an ice also. Its state will change, it will become liquid. Right? I'm not touching that scenario right now. I'm just talking about scenario where the states remains same. If initial state is liquid, it will remain liquid. If initial state is solid, it remains solid. Now tell me one thing. There will be hot objects, there will be colder objects. Calorimeter is this bucket, let's say. Okay? Which will have a copper coating inside. Will this calorimeter also absorb heat or release heat? Can it does? It can do. It can, right? So you need to take into account the calorimeter also. Fine? So initial temperature of calorimeter will be the temperature of all the objects inside the calorimeter initially, and the final temperature of calorimeter will be the final temperature of everything, which will be constant for all. Getting it? Okay. At times it will be given that calorimeter's water equivalent is 100 gram. What does it mean? It means that calorimeter will absorb same amount of heat as if 100 gram of water would have absorbed. Fine? Understood? So all these finer nuances will be there in problem solving. May not be at your school level, but when you solve J level questions, there will be such nuances. Okay?